Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
This is Del Morgado.
Hello, this is Andrew Chalmers, the writer and doctor in Doctor Who Dark Journey.
Hello, this is Dr. Steve-O.
Hi, this is Tim Rose, who played Admiral Ackbar in Return of the Jedi.
Good evening, folks. This is James Duval.
This is Jeremy Taggart from the Taggart and Torrance podcast.
Hey, what's the sitch? This is Kim Possible.
Hiya, Puddins. Mandy Cowell here.
Hey, I'm DJ Jenny Rock.
And I'm Neil Young from Neil and Johnny Drink in the Park, Johnny's best friend.
Hey, this is Andrew Cassess, Wormser from Revenge of the Nerds.
This is Sean Gunn.
Hey, everyone. It's Tammy Stronach from The Neverending Story.
Hi, this is Robert Carradine.
Hey, this is Loki Quinn Cosplay.
Hey, what's cracking, y'all? It's your boy J-Rock. You know, I'm Siri Ira Igra. You listen to Droids Canada podcast.
Huh? Enjoy your chimichanga.
This podcast is a proud member of the Points of Interest Podcast Network. Visit us today at poipodcast.com.
You're listening to the Electronic Media Collective Podcast Network. Yeah, it's a mouthful. For more great shows, like the one you're about to enjoy, visit electronicmediacollective.com. And now, our feature presentation.
Warning! Listener discretion is advised.
That means there's a lot of f***ing swearing.
Hello.
The wild dogs growl in the night. I say your restless longing for some solitary company. I know that I must do what's right. As sure as Kilimanjaro rises like Olympus above the Serengeti. I seek to cure what's deep inside, fighting off this thing that I've become. Come and take a lot to drag me away.
No? I mean, I could put the Weezer version on instead if you prefer that.
No.
Why?
No.
What's going on?
You know there's only one version to play of that song.
The one by Weezer.
You want to get punched, don't you?
I might. What's it? Welcome back to the show, AJ. It's been so long since you've been here. I can tell you're like, oh, I needed to be a part of a podcast.
I'm tired as fuck.
Oh my god, I am sorry, Pookins.
I was gonna like growl in the mic, but now I don't have energy.
Exactly. Come on, seriously, how are you fucking tired? You're gonna be up for another 3 hours, anyways.
Yeah, probably.
So drink your coffee.
I already have.
Drink your coffee. Have pepperoni.
Pepperoni's all gone, man.
You ate all that fuck. You
I
fat fuck.
Ate all that. That's right.
You fat fuck.
I need my protein.
That's not. Don't. No. That's
and
too
I didn't
much.
Even eat it all. You fucking ate three.
Oh my god. Three out of how many?
12.
You fat fuck.
Maybe I should go home and crush three boxes of Kraft dinner.
So we did a little bit of an upgrade while you were gone.
You did an upgrade?
I'm not going to read the card anymore.
Oh.
I'm not going to read the
fucking
card.
Time.
So we're going to throw it over to Mark.
He still did not memorize it.
Nope.
Just to let everybody know, he did not memorize
I
it.
I refused
He's
to.
Lazy as fuck.
I did. I am.
Got someone else to do it for him.
And Mark.
Thanks, guys. You can find their award-nominated podcast that is recorded in Todd's studio, in his apartment, on the following. The Tangent Bound Network, Spotify, Laughable Podcast Network, iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher Radio, Electronic Media Collective, Podbean, and the Points of Interest Network. And, of course, you can find us on our social media, on the Facebooks, at Droids Canada. You can find us on the Twitter, at Droids Canada. On Instagram, at the_droids_Canada. And the final place for all your geek needs, at droidscanada.com. That's it for me. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Mark. You should do it this way. You can find us on the Twitter. Oh, my God.
No, you are totally failing today.
No. Did someone play the knob? Hold on. Someone played with the knob. Who played with
you,
the knob?
You fucked up.
Oh, hold on. Wait, that's you.
You fucked up.
Is that the one? Hold on. That one? That one? That one?
Oh.
Is it that one?
I don't know.
Maybe it's this one.
No.
Let me give it a test run?
You give it a test run.
You can find us on the Twitter.
Better.
Is that better? Because you're the one who actually enjoys that part.
No, not really.
I do. Come on. You enjoy it just a little bit.
Maybe a little bit.
Not too much.
I just have no fucks tonight.
Why did I invite you over to do a podcast? You seemed so chipper earlier.
I'm getting fucking tired.
I'm sorry that you're tired, Pookins. I'm sorry. Anyways, what are we talking about today, AJ? Something went down.
Stupid fucking shit.
Oh, maybe I might get you to be a little bit chipper. Hold on, let me throw something on in the background.
Fuck Disney.
Why?
Fuck them up, their stupid asses.
What? Why? Tell me.
Because they fired someone.
Well, okay.
Over old shit.
Over shit?
Old shit.
Okay. Go on, I'm listening. Go ahead.
Old shit.
Old shit.
Yes, old shit.
Like, we mean old shit.
What was it, 7 years old?
Okay.
7-year-old tweets, Mr. James Gunn.
I mean, if it's on the internet, it's fair game.
Yeah. Well, if everyone was accountable for anything they ever said on social media, Facebook, Twitter, whatever,
sure,
no one would have a fucking job.
That is a pretty valid point. Would you have a job? You don't ever post anything on this
one. I don't post much.
No. So yeah. I guess you would have a job.
I might. I'm one of the rare
ones.
They
realize that you're an asshole, though.
Well, yeah, everyone knows I'm a dick.
I mean, I'm just
can't hold that against me.
Well, we can.
You could try.
We can try.
You can try.
Okay, so let's do into the lead and horn. Do you know the song? I know that I'm a prisoner to all my father. Ooh. I can see the wheels spinning. All his hopes and fears, I just wish I could have told. It's definitely an 80s song.
Oh, I know that.
I think I finally stumped the mountain man.
Mike and the Mechanics?
Mike and the Mechanics. Out of nowhere. You got a little worried there. Field.
I was thinking,
I saw the one sweat.
I was sitting there, like, the beat of sweats got, like, fuck, I should know this.
Man, if anyone knows the 80s, it's between you and Bill.
I don't know. See, Bill was better hair metal.
Oh.
I don't know about, like,
I thought that controlled more
like one-hit wonders, I might have him beat.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, so, let's talk about it. James Gunn, who
successfully directed parts 1 and 2 of Guardians of the Galaxy, even though I hated number 2. I never finished
it. Let's be honest here. I don't think anyone else could have done a good representation of Guardians of the Galaxy. No one knew Guardians of the Galaxy. The hardcore comic book fan would, but I mean, me and you were like,
never read one in my life.
I don't know what's going to happen here. I don't know if I'm going to like this or not. I don't know if I'm going to like this. So, many, many, 7 years ago, he actually did a lot of different types of things. He did trauma films. He did
one of Dan's favorites.
Dan loves sure trauma
he
films.
Loves trauma films.
I figured he'd love to be on this episode, but you know, he's not.
Apparently, other stuff's more important. He just didn't want me to crush him in movie music trivia.
Well, yeah, that was kind of embarrassing. It's kind of, you listened to that episode.
I did.
It was a little bit embarrassing at one point. Well, so she
may have to revisit that.
So we got a couple things we can talk about today, but we're going to start with this one.
There's a bunch.
All right. I don't know. Is music going to fit the situation? I don't know.
Do we need, like, Cannibal Corpse?
I might have Cannibal Corpse.
Or something like Goat Whore?
Goat Whore? What's with you and Goat Whore?
It's always the one joke metal band I go to. Well, they're not a joke, but just because it's a funny name.
I don't even know what this is. Confunction. Pride and Glory.
The fuck?
I don't even know why what?
You should do, like, Living in America.
It's probably on here somewhere.
Well, you played it for Dan the one day.
Yes, then it is on here.
For Rocky.
What the fuck is this? Hold on.
Because I think it's kind of appropriate living in America and the fucking bullshit PC world we're trying to live in.
Don't.
Come on. Find it.
What's this song?
I don't know.
Oh.
This shit right here is called Thou Shalt Not Fall. Not what I thought it was.
That's a remix. And you know why his name
is on point, because he's on point. Not what I thought it was.
I don't even know what this is. I'm on a warpath. Okay, I don't know whose music this is or how it got on my computer, but I promise you that is not my music.
Obviously someone's.
Oh, it's my ex-girlfriend from 10 years ago.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I remember she used to make me burn CDs for her and shit. I never asked questions. I just burned the CDs.
You're okay, supposed hold on, to delete the music when you're done.
There we go.
It's not going to be as good as living in America.
This song. Armageddon. I like this song. Fine. You're looking at me like that. Where is it? James Gunn tweeted on... I'm going to do only the good ones. My new film, Jerk Loose, a small town where beating off is illegal, and one high school kid jerks off in front of other ones to show how fun it is. That could make some money, I guess.
The invention of the circle jerk.
I saw this one earlier, made me laugh my ass off. This is in 2010. Like, was even Twitter even popular then?
No, not really.
The Hardy Boys and the mystery of what it feels like when Uncle Bernie fists me.
Wasn't there a hashtag on that one?
Hashtag sad children's books.
Yeah, it's called a hashtag game.
What?
Heaven forbid. You know, you make a bad comment on.
Okay, this one's a little bit out of bounds. You gotta say it's. You gotta be honest. It's out of bounds. The Expendables was so manly, I fucked the shit out of the little pussy boy next to me. The boys are back in town. That one's kind of bad. There's just. You know, I get the jokes he's trying to make, but a lot of pedophile-ish shots. See, this one's really bad. Three men and a baby they had sex with. Hashtag unromantic movies.
Yeah, but that's not...
That's not funny, even.
It's no different than when they had hashtag wars on, you know, freaking...
But they never, did anything that dark.
Not necessarily, like, the people on it. Well, actually, no. Okay, there was quite a few.
Like, little kid references on this.
There was quite a few that were kind of a little sketchy.
Little?
On At Midnight.
Photo shoot with at Amelia, at Stevie Sparkle, and at Melissa's Pizza. I'd eat that. Trying to maintain a semi-chub so that I look impressive in all these photos. That'd be somewhat
nothing
funny.
Wrong with that.
Someone
hey, if you want to show off your package, be my guest.
At least your own, I guess.
Yeah.
But, you know, here's the thing, and I know this is where it's going to spark the conversation. Why did we go back up to 10 years to look for these things?
Why do we care? Twat.
I'm not going to sit here and excuse his action. Oh, you really did. Just don't pop the peas. Popping the peas is really bad. Stop popping the fucking peas. I'm popping the fucking teeth. Anyways.
How about a pop? Are you going to pop me in the mouth?
So tell me. You said you don't want to. You didn't want to say it earlier. So tell me. Spit gold.
I forgot what I was going to say now.
Oh my God.
I totally did.
Oh my God.
Well, the big one is what I said earlier, though. Like, if everyone had to be held accountable, they would not have
a job.
That's
what the internet is. The internet's not about being held accountable.
Yeah, I'm offended by something you said 7 years ago.
I feel like we're beating a dead horse about it, because we brought this up in the...
Oh, now I remember exactly where I was going to go. Oh, okay.
Hold on, wait. Where's my water? God damn it.
Fuck.
I brought it in here.
No, you didn't.
Damn it.
Tough. Are you good now? I know you don't have your water. Are you good?
I'll make it.
Okay. So we were talking about Chris Hardwick and everything that's gone down.
Right.
Everyone having his back. The only person that's against him is, of course, Chloe.
Right.
with her mounds of proof of video and text. And
that we're still waiting to see?
That we're still waiting to see. But then we also have Bill Cosby, who is being convicted. What was it? Three counts of aggravated some kind of assault.
Something.
They didn't call it rape. But yet, hold on.
Holding.
How many fucking stations are still showing the goddamn Cosby Show on TV? Yet,
I honestly don't know.
He's convicted. Three counts. Convicted. He's a criminal. James Gunn just said some things off the cuff.
We can't do that.
7 years ago.
It's 2018. You can't do that.
But it's okay to be a criminal and still be on TV.
But it even goes back to what I was saying earlier about Hulk Hogan. Like, what he did was not excusable, but it happened how many years ago, and you're still hanging him for
it. Was it like 12?
Yeah. Move on.
Yeah.
I think
that's which they did, hence reinstatement.
Well, yeah.
Well, no, there's more behind that.
There's
a lot more behind it.
But the point is that, you know what? We all fuck up. We're all human beings. We all fuck up. We all say things.
I don't fuck up.
Shut up. We all fucking do things that we shouldn't say. We all do things we shouldn't do. Doesn't mean you need to be, like, it's not like he...
Wait, wasn't there a Kobe Bryant joke? Or an R. Kelly joke or two?
Well, what I'm saying is...
Yes, I'm looking at you.
Look at that whiteboard. Look how clean that whiteboard is.
Yeah, that's a clean whiteboard.
I really scrubbed that whiteboard down pretty good if you're curious. I did that all by myself. No, but the point I'm trying to make is that...
Are you saying it's squeaky clean now?
It is. Oh, Jesus. No, I'm just saying that we all say stupid shit.
Yeah.
And you know what? We get caught. We get caught. We don't. That's just
whoever went back and found these, I want to find Tommaso Ciampa. And he can give him a double fucking oil check.
Jesus Christ. No, like, this is fucking stupid that someone sat there and flipped back. How
Seven
many
years.
So
Seven
that,
years.
See, that sounds to me, this is malicious more than anything at this point.
Someone that has, some conservative twat that has nothing better to do.
I wouldn't go that far. It could have been anyone at this point. Because everyone's fucking sensitive now. You can't say boo or anything.
Oh my God.
You can't literally say anything.
You hurt my feelings for something you said to me 10 years ago. You can't even say to someone. Fuck off. Like, punch him in the mouth.
I don't know. Maybe it, and I don't want to say, I don't want to blame generations. I don't want to blame, parental styles or anything to that effect. But when I grew up and someone criticized me for something, I fucking moved on with my life. That was it. Like, it pissed me off. It hurt my feelings. Maybe I cried. Maybe I didn't. But I moved on with my life and I didn't dwell about it.
It's like you skin your knee or some shit.
Yeah. You just move on. Nowadays, you go, hey, man, don't do this. Oh, my God. My life is ruined.
I have PTSD now.
Oh, my God. I have back pain. From it. I mean, shut the fuck up, dude. Like, life...
Life sucks. Get a fucking helmet.
Like, I'm scared to have children in this day and age, because this is what it is now. It's about my feelings. The internet... I get it. The internet has now made it more of a big... And this is the same thing I tell everyone, and people disagree with me straight up about it, is that the internet was created for us to get better in life.
It's pictures
to
of
evolve.
Cats, cake farts, and pornography.
Right, but it was created for us to evolve. And all it's become now is an avenue to be like, hey, if I don't like you... Bang, I just ruined your fucking life. I accuse
and
you of something.
Social justice warriors.
And
big
the
keyboard.
Social justice warriors.
Let me fight with my keyboard.
But, I mean, this was
my dad
me
could
off.
Beat up your dad.
Right, but what could happen to Morgan Freeman? She tried pulling that shit on him, that CNN whatever.
Yeah.
Tried pulling that shit. Oh, yeah, he was making me feel uncomfortable with the comments he was saying and blah, 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 blah. Until she showed the video and then she realized it was not nearly as bad as she claimed it to be.
Yeah.
And on national TV, she realized she fucked up. Like, but that's the other side of this coin, which a lot of people understand. As much as the Me Too movement has been revolutionary, it sounds horrible either way you put it. As revolutionary as it's been, it's also become a detriment, because now people can be easily just as accused and blackballed. Chris Hardwick is a shining example of it.
Well, there was one woman who actually got arrested for it.
Yeah, I remember reading that.
Because she made like 10 claims,
mm-hmm.
you know, against people that... You know, there was no dealings with. Like, nothing had happened. She just falsely accused 10 people, and finally they said, no, you're going to fucking jail for defamation of character.
Like, that's fucking crazy.
Like, it took 10, but, like, come on.
But it's, to me, it's fucking crazy, though, that people think that, like, this is acceptable now. You know, let's do this. Okay, why do we need to do this? Like, just air your grievances with someone.
Everyone needs to have Festivus. It's all about the airing of grievances.
Yeah, but I mean, even if I disagree with you, I'll call you your face. I'll say you're a fucking asshole to your fucking face. I won't go on the fucking internet.
An asshole every day.
But I won't go on the fucking internet to try and get my fucking
feelings
point
are hurt. You called me an asshole. You can't do back. That.
Oh,
you have to apologize now.
No, but
you have to apologize now.
But this is what pisses me off.
No,
this whole James Gunn thing pisses me off.
Stop. You have to apologize.
Nope.
Say you're sorry.
No, go ahead.
Say you're sorry.
Go ahead. Go on the Twitters.
I'm going to fucking go on the Twitter. After this podcast, I'm going on the fucking Twitter.
Go on the fucking Twitter and be like, he made fun of me.
He made fun of me. He called me an asshole and refused to apologize. What a dick.
Fuck. No, this is what pissed me off. This James Gunn thing really fucking pisses me off because this is malicious. Someone went through his fucking Twitter up to fucking 10 years ago and go, there's got to be something wrong with him. He can't be this squeaky clean. The world can't love him this much. Oh, he's going to get all these new perks. He's going to do an Amazon TV show. He's going to do this. He's doing another Guardians. And he's a very well-respected director. And the fuck... Oh, my God. He did some fucking really weird tweets 10 years ago. Better bring it up.
I hope Guardians 3 fucking bombs.
Oh, my God.
I hope it
Don't
bombs.
Don't say that.
I do.
Don't say that.
I do. Fuck Disney.
Why are you blaming Disney for it?
They're the ones that fired him.
Disney's doing the exact same thing that everyone else has done. You can't even blame Disney for it. AMC. Yeah, AMC fucking dropped Hard Like a Bad Habit.
Yeah, that's fine. Hey, hold on. Innocent until proven guilty.
Well, this is 2018. It's
doesn't matter.
It's the other way around.
Doesn't matter.
Other way around. I fucking hate. I'm not saying agreeance with you. I fucking hate it. I think it's fucking stupid.
I wish people would go after those particular companies.
Here's the point.
Especially Hardwick, with what he has done with his company, and they dropped his name off of everything.
I don't even know how I'd react to that.
Excuse me?
Yeah, he created the company.
He started it from the ground up, and now you're going to remove all references?
Well, we don't know the complete background. Like maybe he said, you know what, just scrub me to be on the safe side.
I doubt he did that. Why would you remove yourself?
Oh. The Italian Jedi might appear.
Oh, maybe we could do movie music version 2.
We could. Maybe we'll compile that for the second episode.
Hurry up.
Okay.
Tell him to hurry the fuck
up. He's going
to
say 5 minutes, tack 25 to what he said. Jesus.
I'm telling him right now.
Okay. Anyways. But the point I'm trying to make is that... that's the thing, though. None of these bigger companies want to get involved. They want to bow out right away so they don't get hit with any of it. That's why fucking WWE did what they did to Hulk Hogan. They just wanted to get away from it as fast as possible. As soon as they found out about the sex tapes and all the allegations in the Gawker, and then when they ultimately found out what Hulk Hogan said recorded, they're like, oh, we got to jazz hands our way out of this one. We don't want the negative press. I understand that. That I understand. But because
negative press
here's
regarding
the thing.
Gawker?
Let me finish. What Hulk Hogan said and it was recorded.
Oh, that wasn't Gawker. That was completely different.
Well, it came up part of that Gawker suit, actually. I watched the whole
Gawker
thing.
Well, the Gawker was a sex tape.
Right, but they had in that whole package is where they had the recording in that package of him making the comment. But that's different compared to Hardwick. Hulk Hogan actually had evidence indicating that he did X, Y, and Z or whatever, whereas there is no evidence that links Chris Hardwick. So that's where which goes with your comment of, you know, he's guilty till proven innocent. It should be the other way around.
Yeah.
So my question is why doesn't the bigger companies do this? Why doesn't the bigger companies go, you know what? Until we have substantial proof.
Exactly.
Maybe we should let this play out. And I understand. The first thing that's going to come to mind is, well, what happens to ratings? Think they're going to drop? True fans of the network, of Chris Hardwick, go, well,
I'll watch anything he does.
I'll watch anything he does. Like, he didn't do anything wrong.
Nope.
Do you think people stop watching The Cosby Show when
they've already lined up a new host for Talking Dead?
Yeah, it was the girl that was kind of there once in a while.
She's like the super fan.
Yeah.
I can't remember what her name.
Which a lot of people were not happy about that either.
Well, you have to do something. Wait. It's not like she's taking his job. She's filling in for a friend.
Right.
I just can't remember her name. It's like a three names, I think. But she's on like every other episode.
Right.
So she's taking over while he's
taking a hiatus. But, so, sorry. Oh my God, hold on. iTunes. Sorry. She did have a little bit of a sore throat, like a little dampness in my throat.
What, cocking your throat?
Oh, I'm offended. I'm going to go on Twitter now.
That's right. My dad, I won't apologize because you didn't apologize to me, fucko.
My dad can out-tweet your dad.
Oh, shit. My dad don't even know what a tweet is.
Oh, but just this whole James Gunn thing, when I saw it earlier today, I was like... I literally just shook my head.
I saw it, like, what was it, like 3 days ago or something?
Well,
and yeah. I've seen so many posts on Facebook and Twitter, and I'm just like, this is fucking dumb. I'm just getting sick of this bullshit.
It's just
like, I'm just waiting, you know, in the next 3 days, who else is going to, you know, come out with some comment? Oh, and they get fired, and then someone else is going to get fired, and it's just stupid. It's just stupid.
But the thing that really bothers me is that, oh, I can't do that. I was just tinkering with something, and I
don't tinker. Stop doing it while we're recording.
Oh, my God.
Stop.
Didn't mean to.
Step.
Step. Rick. Rick. Step. Step. Rick, don't do it. Step.
Step.
But it's just so frustrating to me that someone was just that malicious to go back and do that. And
some people are douchebags.
Apparently. Oh, my goodness. Now it just froze up.
There's not having any luck today.
What's that?
You're just not having any luck.
No. No.
I sent Dan a message, but he did not receive it. Tell him to hurry up. We're going to do movie music part 2.
Well, he wants to come over and do a quick show and then go to a freaking band. Go watch a band. I don't know.
Where?
At the Peter Piper's Pit or whatever it is in Fawn Hill. It's actually a nice place.
It's fucking 11:30. By the time he gets here, it's going to be midnight.
It's not my business. Jesus.
And then by the time he gets there, the way he drives, it's going to be 1 o'clock, 1:30. Well, because he'll get here by midnight. We'll probably record about a half hour with Danmo.
Well, he said it was on Ellenberg
he'll
Bridge.
Leave here.
I don't even know why he thinks
he's going to be able to see it. It'll be a half hour before he gets here, the way he drives.
He's got
the cruise control set at 35.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
See, I told you I listened to the show.
Oh, God.
I always listen to the ones I'm not on.
Well, look at you. Look at you.
Why listen to the ones I was on? I was already fucking there.
I think you remember them all.
I don't.
No. Some of them are pretty funny.
I'm sure.
I was listening to the one the other day.
When you repost them, I'll listen to them. I just don't go back through the catalog.
I know one you won't go back to.
Which one?
The one with me and Dan yarling at you.
Oh, fuck. As soon as I hear the yarl, I skip like 8 minutes of the podcast.
Like, I can literally hear your anger through the microphone.
I wanted to throw my iPad when I heard that the one day.
Oh, man. Oh, I think that's all I got, man. Are we done ranting for now?
I don't know.
Do
we have anything on the up and coming? I don't know.
Just Fan Expo, really.
Yeah, that's it.
I mean, that's it.
We still got to figure out photo ops.
Oh, we know one for sure.
Shepherd.
Oh, Crowley, of course.
Yeah.
Just got to figure out. I think that one would just end up being me and you. I don't think Dan would be in it.
I don't even know. Dan will probably do Biff. Because didn't he want to do Biff, like, last year?
Yeah, Biff canceled.
And he canceled. So he'll probably want to do Biff.
Biff was
too
busy.
Which is cool, because I liked him in Freaks and Geeks.
Biff's schedule was too busy. He needed to clear it a little bit.
Yeah.
So. All right.
We'll have to figure that out in the next little while.
Yeah. All right. Well, I guess we can wrap up this episode.
We can?
We can. I want to see if you can think of something else.
I can't think of anything.
I can't think of anything else. So we'll just end it up with a classic.
With a classic? Who's going to do it? Mother?
Yeah.
Danzig.
All right.
I'm rocking today. Dan's in trouble.
You going to say it or I'm going to say it?
Bye-bye. Tell your children not to hear my words, what they mean, what they say. Mother. Mother. Can you keep them in the dark for a while? Can you?